Good evening. Merry Christmas. A couple of announcements as we begin. There are two ways we do communion. You can either pick up a prepackaged kit from the usher, and if anyone wants to do that, please raise your hand now and they will bring it to you. Or else you just follow the instructions from the usher when they come around. As to the candle lighting later in the service, please tip your unlit candle to the flame of the lit one. The Christmas proclamation. One moment. Matt, do you have an announcement?
I just want to take a minute here to recognize our paid staff here at Trinity, Pastor Denise, Sandra Winger, and Carol Hughes. Just want to let you all know how much we really appreciate what you do for our church, your tireless efforts, and we couldn't do what we do without you. So I want to thank you all for your what you do. Although you're paid staff, we know we don't pay you what you're worth. So big thank you to both of you and to Carol Hughes, who's not here tonight. So as a little appreciation, we took up a special offering that we would like to give to the three of you. Just a little token to show you how much we appreciate it. Can everybody show your appreciation?
Now the Christmas proclamation. Many ages from the time when God created the heavens and the earth, and then formed man and woman in his own image. Long after the great flood, when God made the rainbow shine forth as a sign of the covenant. 21 centuries from the time the promise was given to Abraham and Sarah. 13 centuries after Moses led the people of Israel out of Egypt and Miriam danced in freedom. 1,100 years from the time of Ruth and the Judges. 1,000 years from the anointing of David as king in fulfillment of the times and years and months and days discerned by the prophets. In the 194th Olympiad, the 752nd year from the foundation of the city of Rome, the 42nd year of the reign of Augustus Caesar, while the whole world enjoyed a span of peace, Jesus Christ, eternal God and Son of the eternal Father, desiring to sanctify the world by his most merciful coming, being conceived by the Holy Spirit, and 9 months of growth in the womb of his mother Mary. Now in our own times is the nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, God made flesh.
Thank you.
Please stand. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Almighty God, you have made this new night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth, we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day, wake to the brightness of your glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. The first reading for this evening was taken from Isaiah, the 9th chapter. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them a light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born to us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The second reading this evening is taken from Titus, the 2nd chapter. The grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impiety and worldly possessions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He it is who gave himself for us, that for us he might redeem us from all our iniquity and purify himself a people of his own who are zealous for good deeds. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Source the end.
The Holy Gospel according to Luke, the second chapter. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
The world's redeemed.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. On Christmas night, all Christians sing to hear the news the angels bring. That's a hymn or carol that's found in our ELW hymnal. Familiar to some folks, not so familiar to others, but truly a wonderful carol. The Oxford Book of Carols, the foremost authority on Christmas and Advent carols, and lists over 200 carols with elements of their origin and history, both words and music. Now, they're a little more lax these days, as many of the songs that we refer to as Christmas carols are really not carols at all, but songs. Carols themselves have a certain dance rhythm, and they're songs that one could easily dance to. Dance to. Something we really wouldn't think about doing in a church, would we? But in light of all the carols proclaiming Christ's birth, it would indeed be perfectly appropriate. Many of the carols give salvation history in such detail that they could be used to instruct or catechize people in the faith. For instance, "Tomorrow Shall Be My Dancing Day" is a carol that dates back before the Reformation and is Jesus telling his story from his baptism and temptation to his passion, resurrection, and ascension. There are many others like it. The Holly and the Ivy, the Seven Joys of Mary, and more that teach in their verses the Christian faith. When we consider the prophecies fulfilled, the promises kept this night in the birth of God's Son, Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world, why not sing and dance for joy? Why not sing and rejoice for the change that his birth ushers in, not just 2,000 plus years ago, but the changes ushered in for our day as well? Why not rejoice and be merry? Rejoice and be merry in songs and in mirth. Oh, praise our Redeemer, all mortals on earth. For this is the birthday of Jesus our King, who brought us salvation, his praises we'll sing. Why not joy to the world and all the rest? It is fitting to be merry, to be happy on this night of all nights, knowing that God loved us so much that he sent his Son, born in a crude manger, to be our salvation. But while we are laughing and singing and dancing for joy at his birth, let us not forget the lessons he taught us. Let's remember this tiny baby that upset the course of the world, the one who turned things upside down and ushered in a change in how we relate to one another, especially how we relate to the poor, the lonely, the hungry, the displaced, the needy, the grieving. The one who cast down the mighty from their thrones and sent the rich away empty. He is the one who brings a new teaching, a teaching to love God alone above all else and to love our neighbors as well as we love ourselves. And even more, a command to love our enemies. He commands us to go the extra distance for those in need, to do more than the law requires us to do. It's our time to change our world in his name and to bring peace to our violent society and safety to our children. And so on this night, let us look to a new day. A world turned upside down by a tiny baby born in a manger, who effected salvation for us all. We give thanks to God for the wonderful counselor, the Prince of Peace, who unseats the proud and lifts up the lowly, not with the hand of a mighty warrior, but with the tiny, warm, soft hand of a baby. Rejoice, for on this night you have been marked for salvation. Dance and sing for joy, because God loves you. And may we with the angels proclaim, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill to all people. Amen.
As you are able, please stand. Trusting in God's good news of great joy for all people, we offer our prayers for ourselves, our neighbors, and the world God loves. Glory to you, God, for the song of angels, proclaiming to the world Christ's holy birth. Give your church a joyful song to sing, that we bring the good news of peace and salvation to all people. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Glory to you, God, for the stars that shine in the depth of night. Provoke all in our hearts and the expansive mystery of the cosmos. Open us to find beauty in the clear darkness of night and in the first glimmers of dawn. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Glory to you, God, for the child born to us who establishes a kingdom of justice and righteousness. Break bonds of oppression, bring reconciliation to warring lands, and establish peace from this time onward and forevermore. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Glory to you, God, for Mary's loving care. Lead us to tend one another in a time of need. Share the comfort of your presence with all the people tonight who are alone or separated from loved ones due to estrangement, incarceration, or illness. Tonight we especially pray for Gustin Mimi, Joyce, Barbara, Marie, Sue, Elizabeth, Terry and Laura, Shirley, Charles and Nancy, Sally, Dick, Jake, Tracy, Doug, Linda, Ray, Bud, Donna, Nora, and Josie. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Glory to you, God, for the faithfulness of the shepherds and their vocation. Grant rest to any who feel exhausted from their work during this season. Retail and restaurant workers, church musicians, administrative staff, and clergy, organizers of charitable events, and service workers doing essential tasks. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Glory to you, God, for the multitude of the heavenly host. We rejoice in zeal of all your saints who have witnessed the appearing of your grace, who reveal us to your salvation for all. Hear us, O God. Abide with us, O God of mercy, and receive our prayers according to your abundant grace. Amen.
Thank you.
As you are able, please stand. God of abundance, receive and bless these gifts in our hearts with the song of the angels and gather us at your table of celebration. Strengthen us to share with all of the world the abundance of your grace upon grace. Jesus Christ, Word made flesh. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift up
your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to love the God whom we cannot see. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks and broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, we pray the prayer our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Those communing with the prepackaged kits, open the top seal, take out the bread, the body of Christ given for you. Open the seal over the wine, the blood of Christ shed for you. Please stand. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
God, our Redeemer, you have fed us at this table with gifts of grace, truth, and life. As you have gathered us in joy, send us forth as a message of your peace. Make us shine with the good news of your glory, born to us in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
A reminder, with the candle lighting, tip the unlit candle to the flame.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, whom were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Mother and child.
God bless you and keep you. Jesus grant you grace and truth. And the Spirit send peace upon your hearts, now and forever. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Christ the Savior is born. Go in peace. Proclaim the good news.